Good evening. This is Bill Hamilton of the DuPont Company speaking from the stage of the Playhouse in Wilmington, Delaware, where the DuPont Cavalcade of America brings you Christmas greetings as we did last year with a program of the world's best-loved Christmas carols sung by the DuPont Chorus. 129 men and women of the DuPont Company under the direction of Daniel W. Boyer. Later in this program, Mr. Walter S. Carpenter, Jr., president of the DuPont Company, will speak. Our program begins as the chorus sings the joyous Carol of the Bells. Christmas carols have blossomed from the hearts of people all over the world. The men and women who sing these carols for you tonight work in DuPont laboratories, DuPont offices, and DuPont plants, a cross-section of the company which brings you better things for better living through chemistry. This chorus came into being 4 years ago when a small group of men and women began to meet regularly and sing for their own enjoyment. And now we hear them in two well-loved carols, first one of England's finest, When the Crimson Sun is Set. And now a 14th century Latin composition, In Dulci Jubilo.
Thank you.
In our second group of Christmas carols, with the ever-popular and early Italian lyric, Lo, How a Rose E'er Blooming. The hearty and widely sung old English carol, God Rest Ye Merry Gentlemen.
God rest you merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. Remember Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day, to save us all from Satan's power when we were gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy.
Next, the DuPont Chorus sings two sacred and traditional carols dedicated to the Nativity. First, the well-known children's carol by Martin Luther, Away in a Manger. An inspiring hymn from the British Isles. Angels from the Realms of Glory.
Angels from the Realms of Glory.
complete this choral setting with the reverent and inspiring carol familiar to us all, O Holy Night. Mr. J. Clark Gonzalez of the DuPont Chambers Works, Pensgrove, New Jersey, will be the soloist, and the organ accompaniment will be played by Mr. Branson Fry of the DuPont Engineering Department. Now, O Holy Night.
Thank you.
are listening to the DuPont Cavalcade of America Christmas greeting by the DuPont Chorus of 129 voices coming to you from the stage of the Playhouse in Wilmington, Delaware. At this time, we are to hear from the president of the DuPont Company, Mr. Walter S. Carpenter, Jr. Mr. Carpenter.
The Christmas broadcast of the DuPont Company last year gave me an opportunity to greet the Cavalcade listeners, and particularly the men and women on the DuPont plants and offices throughout the country who are my business associates. Tonight, that opportunity comes again, and I welcome it. The DuPont Company has this last year produced more goods for the American people and for shipment abroad than in any peacetime year in the company's history. The good work of 74,000 men and women across the country made this possible. But good work as individuals would not have made it possible. There had to be, and there has been, a fine spirit of cooperation throughout the company. That same cooperation and harmony that has made possible the beautiful singing of the Christmas carols that we have so enjoyed tonight. I want to thank all of them for this. Meanwhile, upon the broader scene, we find men and women and children in other lands less fortunate. We cannot close our ears or our hearts to the appeals that come to us from over the seas, from our fellow human beings who suffer still from the unhealed wounds of the war. They appeal to us to lessen the hardships of cold and of hunger throughout the winter. We Americans shall respond to this appeal, I think, because we are a compassionate people, and because we feel that in doing so, we will make a contribution to the peace of the world. We hope, too, that in doing this, we will encourage those people to seek and perhaps one day attain those benefits of freedom and liberty which we here enjoy and which contribute so much to our capacity to aid them in this period of great emergency. May this Christmas prepare the way for a new year of hope for all of us.
Thank you, Mr. Carpenter. The Cavalcade of America continues with the DuPont Chorus singing one of the best loved of all Christmas carols, O Come, All Ye Faithful. Of this next group is the great holiday anthem, All Men Now Sing, by Johann Sebastian Bach.
Oh,
From the 16th century Coventry Corpus Christi play, we hear an adaptation from The Pageant of the Shearman and the Tailor, Coventry Carol. Complete the group, the famous old carol sung for many years the world over, Deck the Hall. DuPont Chorus closes this program of Christmas carols with what is probably the favorite of all Christmas hymns, Silent Night. We are asking our audience here in the theater to join in singing with the chorus. And we hope that you at home, from coast to coast, will sing along with us too, if not in voice, at least in your heart. To the DuPont Cavalcade of America, sending Christmas greetings to you from the stage of the Playhouse in Wilmington, Delaware. Our DuPont chorus of 129 voices, accompanied by Virginia B. Williams of DuPont's Organic Chemicals Department, is under the direction of Daniel W. Boyer and has brought you Christmas carols of many lands and many times. This is the second year the DuPont chorus has been heard Christmas week on our nationwide Cavalcade broadcast. And we hope you will accept these carols with their words of inspiration and good tidings as the expression of heartfelt Christmas greetings from the men and women of the DuPont Company. Next Monday night, the Cavalcade of America brings you one of Hollywood's loveliest and brightest young stars, Joan Caulfield, in an original radio play, Powhatan's Daughter. We invite you to listen. This is Bill Hamilton of the DuPont Company wishing you all a very Merry Christmas. This is NBC, the National Broadcasting Company.